Hey guys, Taki here. We've got an exciting video to go over today. There is a brand new emulator for the Android platform, and in this video, we're gonna go over it. Whenever we get these new releases, it's kind of like the Super Bowl for anyone that likes to emulate on Android. We get shafted on this platform, as there are a ton more emulators that are available on x86 compared to Android, but we do have great hardware that we're waiting to put to use. This newest emulator is going to allow us to play Vita games on our Android phones or devices, and the performance is actually pretty decent compared to the initial releases of other emulators to the platform. The majority of this video is going to look at the performance of this new emulator, but before we can do that, we need to talk about the emulator itself. Now, I'm assuming that you've never used the Vita 3K emulator on x86 before, so I will talk about some of the shortcomings of that emulator compared to some of the other emulators that have been ported over to Android. If we use Aether SX2, for example, when that emulator was ported over, the base emulator that it was based off of was already very far into development, with almost every game playable on a wide selection of hardware. Vita 3K is not like that. There are not a lot of games that are fully playable on the platform without bugs or graphical issues, and performance between different hardware is pretty much hit or miss. Another example would be the Citra emulator. When that was ported over to Android, the desktop version of that emulator was already decent with select GPUs. So when the initial version of that emulator was ported over to Android, they weren't still building the ship while they were trying to sail it as much as Vita 3K is. This emulator needs a lot of work, but I'm hoping that the added interest that this emulator is going to get with this Android port will allow it to advance faster than it has in the past. I want to be very upfront before we go any further that this emulator does have great performance on low-end hardware for some games, but it does have a lot of unique bugs and issues that you'll find as you test different hardware. I want to illustrate that with a few examples, and in front of us right now, I have two Snapdragon phones. The top one is a Snapdragon 8 Gen 2, and the bottom one is a 888 Plus. It might seem weird that I've gone ahead and selected a 888 Plus, but I've done that for a good reason. The reason is that this is one of the highest-end Snapdragon processors that uses an Adreno 600 series GPU. That's important because that's going to allow us to use custom GPU drivers, and those are going to allow us to play games that we cannot play on the newer and more powerful Snapdragon 8 Gen 2. This is something that we've seen in Skyline, but it's also something that we're seeing in this new emulator. I have three examples to illustrate this. Two where a game will completely crash on the newer processor, and one where the older processor has improved performance while the newer one does not. That kind of seems a bit strange, but we're going to take a look at it right now. Let's start with the games that cannot run on the newer 8 Gen 2 processor. Our first one is Ninja Gaiden Sigma Plus. So here we have Ninja Gaiden Sigma Plus loading up on both of these. And the bottom phone again is that 888 Plus with the Adreno 600 series GPU using custom GPU drivers. As you can see, both of these phones are able to boot up this game, but if we progress a bit further, the top one will crash while the bottom one will be able to continue to play. Alright, so we are at the point where the newer processor will crash out and the bottom one will not, and it should happen right after I press this X button to proceed. So as you can see, the 8 Gen 2 has crashed, and the 888 Plus is able to continue playing the game. There are two ways to look at this. If you have older hardware, that means that you're going to get better performance than someone that has a flagship Android processor at this point. But on the other hand, it kind of sucks that you aren't getting the best performance with the best hardware. Okay, we've got another example of a game that will crash on the newer processor while it will be able to continue running on the older one, and this one happens right at the beginning of the game. As you can see, the top one has crashed, and the bottom one is going to slow down a bit, but then it's going to be able to continue going. It's kind of a moot point because this game will crash on this phone later on as you progress through the story, but it's another example of the older processors performing better than the newer ones with this emulator. Our final game is a game that will crash on both devices, but before it crashes, it is running significantly faster on the older Snapdragon 888 Plus processor. Okay, so these are both loading up right now. They're not fully in sync, but I think you can clearly see that the newer processor is running way slower than the older one. The FPS reading is on screen right now, and you can see that the newer processor is about half of the older one. I also need to point out that both of these processors are running with the maximum clock speeds for the GPU and CPUs. So this should be the most performance that you can expect at this point from either of these processors. As the battle loads in, you can see things even out a bit, but both of them end up crashing in the end. It's not all bad though, and there is a lot of promise here with what we can see in this initial release, especially when it comes to games like Uncharted that don't run at all on some of the Windows handhelds that are out there right now. If you saw my Win 4 emulation video, you know that I played Uncharted and it looked like a mess on that game, but it actually runs on the Android phone that I have in front of me. That is something that I did not expect to see at all. So now we're gonna get into the performance section, and I put a big collection of games in here, but I didn't only wanna put games that run well. I put games that run well, games that have issues, and games that outright don't run at all. I hope this collection of games will give you a clear idea of what this emulator can and cannot do. I hope the section before this helps you to understand why some phones with older processors might get better performance than you if you have newer processors like the one that I have in front of me. So let's take a look at those games right now.
Body don't fail me! come on. You really shouldn't do this.
I know, but we were able to come back once, right? If we go in from the same location...
I can tell this one has... Try stuff out and...
うん、初めてにしては上出来だな、シンガ。
What's happened? Get in touch.
All right, cut. How are we? We've learned a
lot.
Understood.
Chamber. Kill him on sight. Dante's orders.
One of Dante's mercenaries. Bastards.
But that's going to wrap up things for this look at the Vita 3K emulator on Android. This is a really exciting time to be into Android emulation, and I can't wait to see where they go with this next. Again, I hope this added interest in this emulator with the Android port is going to allow it to advance much faster than it would have if it just stayed with x86. I plan on putting together a guide after this video to go over some of the tips and tricks that I found after testing this across a lot of devices, and that video should come up after the one that you're watching right now. Happy gaming, everyone!